Hi there, this is Richard Walker from Lucidate. Welcome back to the fascinating world of large language models. As we rapidly move into an era where AI becomes more pervasive in seemingly every industry, one aspect becomes crucial: how we interact with these models. History warns that siloed approaches rarely work, and for any technology to garner widespread adoption, it must integrate with existing systems. The current successful mode of interaction with large language models is by natural language prompts. This has resulted in a new and frequently discussed discipline, something referred to as prompt engineering. So, what exactly is prompt engineering? We'll explore it in much more detail in both this and the next video. Later in this video, we'll look at something called chain of thought prompts, and in the next, self-consistency and react prompts. These are all emerging techniques that are both art and science in carefully crafting prompts that guide the responses of LLMs, ensuring that they provide useful, accurate, and contextually appropriate outputs. It's a bit like asking the right questions to get the answers that you require, but there's a lot more to it than meets the eye. Prompt engineering has been heavily reported in the news recently, if for no other reason than people with the right prompt engineering skills are in very high demand, as evidenced by this job advert from Anthropic offering $375,000 a year for a prompt engineer. In this video and the next, we'll look at prompt techniques and how LangChain provides effective, non-intrusive support for effective prompts. In this video, as mentioned earlier, we'll also look at a technique called chain of thought reasoning. To understand why prompt engineering is crucial and how it works, it's important to grasp the concepts of both parametric and prompt knowledge. Parametric knowledge in LLMs is a lot like your long-term memory or a computer's hard drive. It's the knowledge that's been learned during training and is stored within the model's weights. It's so ingrained that it's hard to forget. Just think back to your school days, the multiplication tables you learned, the historical dates you memorized. That's parametric knowledge. In an LLM, this is the information it's gleaned from the massive amounts of text data during its training phase. Now, imagine you've just looked up a new recipe online. You can remember it for a while, but if you don't keep using the recipe, you'll forget it. This is akin to prompt knowledge in an LLM, similar to your short-term memory or a computer's RAM. It's knowledge that's provided at inference time via the prompt. While parametric knowledge is ingrained, prompt knowledge is more fleeting and context-dependent, but it helps the model respond in a much more nuanced way to specific inputs. So, we have parametric knowledge, the long-term memory of LLMs, and prompt knowledge, the short-term memory. The effective interplay of these two types of knowledge is what makes LLMs such versatile tools, capable of tackling a broad range of tasks and queries. Parametric and prompt knowledge offer interesting methods of interacting with language models and can play a crucial role in how these models comprehend and respond to inquiries. Take, for instance, the model's understanding of mathematical operations. If we ask a GPT model to add two numbers together, it's the parametric knowledge that allows it to understand and perform this task. Parametric knowledge is embedded in the neural weights of the model during the training process, and it includes basic arithmetic, grammatical rules, and general knowledge about the world. On the other hand, prompt knowledge is the model's ability to interpret and respond to the specific phrasing or structure of a query. For instance, if we ask what is 2 plus 2 in a conversational tone, the model would understand the expectation of a straightforward numerical answer. However, if we prompt it differently, such as, "Can you tell me a story that involves the addition of 2 and 2, the model is capable of providing a narrative answer because of its understanding of the prompt's context. Understanding both parametric and prompt knowledge is essential to drive better and more targeted interactions with language models. The fact that these LLMs can continue to develop capabilities after they've been trained is what makes prompt engineering such an exciting field. The fact that these models can learn at inference time with a well-structured prompt is what makes prompt engineers so highly valued. Chain of thought, COT, reasoning, is a strategy implemented to make language models mimic the human reasoning process more closely. It's like bridging the gap between the traditional logic-based systems used in the financial services industry and the intuitive contextual reasoning that human analysts provide. Let's look at an example that's challenging for most humans, let alone LLMs. We'll pose this question. A boat is on a lake. In the hold of a boat is a cannonball. If I drop the cannonball over the side of the boat, it sinks to the bottom of the lake. Does the level of the water in the lake rise, fall, or stay the same? Many people, incorrectly as it turns out, say it stays the same. The correct answer is that the level of the water in the lake drops, very slightly. Here's the correct reasoning. When the cannonball is in the boat, it displaces an amount of water equal to its weight. When the cannonball is dropped into the lake and sinks to the bottom, it displaces an amount of water equal to its volume. We naturally understand through experience that cannonballs have a density greater than 1 and will consequently not float. But we're given confirmation in the question as we're told that the cannonball sinks to the bottom of the lake. If we pose this question to the latest version, GPT 3.5, Da Vinci 3, the engine behind ChatGPT, it gets the answer wrong, but it does so in its usual cheerily assertive way. This is where chain of thought reasoning can come in and help. We can first provide some context and then ask the identical question. This time, it gets the answer correct. Another approach is to ask the LLM to think about it step by step. This is called zero-shot chain of thought. Often simply asking the model to think about things step by step is enough. I found in this case that I had to provide some additional context. Now, if we pose the same question to GPT-4, we see that it gets the answer correct first time and also provides the correct reasoning. This is a great example of how new generation of AI, like GPT-4, can already show improvement over previous versions, even without human intervention. This adaptability, this ability to learn and improve, is a key characteristic that sets these models apart from traditional rule-based systems. It gives us a glimpse of the future where AI models will keep improving, learning more from each interaction, each question asked. An area where large language models often struggle is arithmetic and algebraic problems that require precedence. That is to say, equations where you would use parentheses. Also problems that require solution by simultaneous equations. Now, look, to me, this isn't surprising. These language models weren't explicitly trained to be able to solve mathematics. They were trained on language. What is surprising is that they're able to exhibit the math capabilities that they do. And then what is even more surprising, at least to me, is that with very minor modification to their prompts using zero-shot chain of thought, they can nail problems that they would otherwise struggle with. In this case, we pose the problem, when I was 9, the difference between me and my sister's age was 13 years. Now, the age difference between me and my sister is 1/5 of her age. How old is my sister now? The correct answer is 65. Da Vinci 3 cannot get this. It comes up with the answer of 45, time and time again. However, with a COT prompt to think this through step by step and a first step to get the ball rolling, it's able to reason through the problem and get to the right answer. Once again, GPT-4 gets this right first time, and there's strong evidence, again, at least to Lucidate's eyes, that there is some chain of thought prompting going on behind the scenes. Now, this serves as a great segue to LangChain and its prompt modules. These prompt components can take the input prompt and apply some programming logic to it to come up with an augmented prompt. Remember here that the input will come from the previous element in the chain. Now, this might be a user input, or it might be a result from an application, a document search, or even a prompt generated by another LLM downstream. This is LangChain with its chains of processing elements. Now, if a user had to remember each time to supply quotes, think about this step by step, end quotes, or some other chain of thought augmentation to each prompt, then they'd soon grow tired of this. Plus, depending on the type of prompt, there could be dozens or hundreds of potential prompt augmentations, each one subtly different from the other, but with dramatically different outputs. LangChain's prompt components make this prompt augmentation straightforward. They essentially allow for templated reasoning. This means that when a user or another LLM asks a question, these prompt components can provide a template for instance, chain of thought reasoning, thus ensuring that the model responds optimally. We'll look at these prompt templates in more detail in the next video, but for now, see how they perform the translator role, translating from user input or an output from another upstream LLM into a prompt that will generate an optimum response from the current LLM in the chain. Now, I think there's a possibly commonly held misconception that the term prompt engineer is for someone sitting in front of ChatGPT and coming up with clever prompts. Well, I won't say that they don't ever do that, but I hope this illustration of LangChain's prompt components and how they're used show that the role involves far more than typing in clever prompts to an LLM, and perhaps sheds additional light on why companies like Anthropic place such high value on people with the right skills, knowledge, and experience. As we wrap up this video, let's quickly recap on the exciting insights we've explored. We've dived deep into the world of large language models, explored the essence of prompt engineering, and understood the intricate interplay of parametric and prompt knowledge. The value of skilled prompt engineers cannot be overstated, as we've seen with the impressive salary packages that companies like Anthropic are offering. The power of chain of thought reasoning and its application in LangChain have been showcased, displaying how LLMs can be enhanced to handle complex tasks and provide logical step-by-step responses. In our next video, we'll delve into other prompt techniques such as React, self-consistency, and more, and show how LangChain ensures effective, non-intrusive support for these prompts. We sincerely hope you'll join us for that exploration. In the meantime, if you've enjoyed this video, please consider giving it a thumbs up and subscribing to our channel. Your likes, comments, and shares go a long way in supporting our work and help us reach more people interested in understanding the intriguing world of AI and language models. If you're finding value in our content, we invite you to join our channel as a member to gain access to exclusive perks and deeper dives into these fascinating topics. Remember, every interaction matters. Until next time, this is Richard Walker from Lucidate. Stay curious and keep exploring.